Because they're so heavy, laden with such negativity, I go to a special doctor, a chiropractor that I work with, that's also on a high frequency spiritually from near-death experiences. And he and I heal each other by removing the entities of the curse or something that somebody brought to me, either his practice or mine, that literally can choke or upset the path. It's real. It's just learning how to identify it and not being an effective eraser. I used to write books on the gym and everything. And
yeah,
I lost her how many years ago. I mean,
a couple of years I missed her.
Yeah, I mean, man, you contracted all the best, you know. I just got chills, but you fear. But, no, she gave me the book on gin, I remember, and, it's real. She did all the research. So, it's not that I make it up, it's just I've learned and I've learned to identify, and mainly I just want to help people get out of their, like, the black hole, you know. A lot of people fall in the black hole and they don't know how to get out.
Can anybody curse someone?
I don't know. I think so. I think if you wish it hard enough, they could. But I really think it goes beyond. I think it really has to have some type of magic or the djinn or something really has to be done. I don't think you just say, oh, I'm going to curse you and you're going to have bad luck. It doesn't work that way. Yes, the word is powerful, but not enough to cause an accident or someone to, like, you know, people yelling that you were dead, all of a sudden the person died. They're not that powerful. They didn't cause the death. It's not, it doesn't work that way. But there's celebrities out there that I've worked with and heard from and heard of that do some pretty heavy black magic, and I am not into the black end at all. I don't want the black magic. I don't want that kind of karma. I'm not out to hurt anything. But it's there, and it can be heavy duty, and it can be really detrimental to people's lives, careers, love, weight, health. Yeah, they can juju it. It's getting out of the world if you find out where that portal is to get out.
Evelyn Pack Weary, remember, used to tell us to use different kinds of candles to ward off different kinds of curses.
She's right. She had her line, and I developed my line with the wisdom in 1999. She had hers in the 80s, and I have several that break the curse, the bad luck, the negativity, and receive somebody in money or love or in lost. I think one girl, about 2 years ago, she was a pastor, did a bunch of candles. She was up for 30 years in jail, and I got it. She didn't get punished after the whole lawsuit. She was doing a lot of candles. Yeah, those kind of work because of the oils and the intentions, and if you're doing it properly. Evelyn was more pagan. And mine was based on Centauri and Kabbalah. I kind of made my own thing and got away from the occult to make it mainstream. Everybody has a gift if they do it properly, but not to do harm.
What do you think of prayer, Linda?
Constant. I believe in God in the way that the more I pray, the more I'm at peace. And then the more I surrender to whatever that thing is out there, a higher power, a higher source, and then, you know, some people call it Jesus, some people just call it the higher power, some people call it the light. Whatever it is that you talk to, I saw the light. I saw it in the car accident when I had that white light. I saw it. I felt it. When I get into my free will and I'm trying to control things, everything goes crazy and it doesn't work. I let go. The smooth ride, the path, the flow is mine. And as long as I say a prayer to, hey God, good morning, thank you for another day, or oh, thank you for the parking place. A friend of mine says she would even bless her bed. She's got a bed to sleep in. And if you start blessing and thinking and getting grateful, the door's open. And you just let go. And you see, wow, it's beautiful. The rainbow, the butterflies, and the flowers, you know, as opposed to your brain driving you crazy with anger and resentment and the past. You can curse yourself just by thinking. You know, but the negativity, there's so much.
Are you a believer in feng shui?
I have been, yes. I don't decorate that way, but I do understand the elements and putting different elements in certain parts of the house and the money factor in the bedroom and this. It never worked for me. Whoever did it probably be retired and doing something else. I love feng shui, and I love the wood and the metal and the water and then the stone and everything that it represents. But even when I put little things like, you put something red in this corner and something, you know, metal over there and put some water over here, It balances. I don't know that it's ever seen significant change, and then I've gone to people's homes who are Asian, actually, and everything is so neat and so organized and orderly, and everything's feng shui, and it works if you know how to really have it done. Me? No, I just kind of play with it. But if it's professionally organized, yeah, it's very yin-yang.
Uh-huh. We're going to take calls next hour with Linda, and we will not do readings on people who have died, but we'll do readings on yourself. So you ask her a question, I'll give her your name and city. Linda, very quickly, we have an email in from a lady who is a great listener of the program. She's from Ontario. Her name is Linda, and she just asks if you know if she should sell her condo to buy a detached house when she's 75 years old.
I get two or three bedrooms she's going to release, and she's going to be happy, and I'm going to tell her why. She doesn't want all the people around her anymore. She's not dying. She's a very young 75 person from around these grown-up hippies. You're dating for over 60, you know, the seniors. She's got tons of time ahead, and to be grounded on the ground.
All right, great. Good luck to her. Now, over the last couple of years, you've been nominated, you've been awarded Leadership Achievement Awards. A lot of things are happening for you.
Yeah, it's changed. It's really, it's not just, you know, the fact that I'm really excited that I've had this job for 10 years. I got beyond it. And after Cal Effect went up here in 2009, I didn't know what to do. The podcast was just starting, and I was confused, and somebody who was working for me said, "Oh, start YouTube." And I'm like, "What's that?" And I couldn't even think of starting something new, because after I lost the job at KFI and went dark, my mom passed away. And there was too much in 3 weeks to think of a new career. It was just too overwhelming. So I just kind of did my own thing. But over time, I would say from 2012 up to now, for the last 10 years, I've just focused on helping people. You know, I got my PhD in obese. I had a physics, went back to qualified quantified by the science with the spiritual and the woo-woo to make it real. I call it younger than medical condition. And over the years, with the candles, the radios, and the psychic, I then got into recently more nutrition based on DNA analysis, with a company that I'm an independent distributor for. So I've wrapped it all in clinically as well as spiritually. So I am balanced with the science and the spiritual for the whole body. And someone nominated me for the International Fund of Advancements in Healthcare that was last lockdown. I got an award, top 100 in the country. And I just did that song on April. They had me leave. I was a speaker. And got another award. And this one was from Health 2.0, and it was top leadership in health. Yeah.
You're like the modern Edgar Cayce.
You know what? I was told I was an Edgar Cayce, like an Edgar Cayce. Back when I was on KID, long before it became stale, there was a woman who used to call me. She was Edgar Cayce, photographer in the 40s.
Wow.
She gave me, I'm going to say, she's 91 then, and that was 30 years ago. She gave me a photograph of Edgar, his wife, and my son. I have a black and white copy of the photo. She took of them. I sent a copy to ARE in West Virginia years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I've been told, even when I can say these people used to hear the communication of the way I read or talk, like a Casey. I can hear like the 6-7 times I've heard that knowledge at the bank. Yeah, I am.
I sense that a lot.
Whether or not the people call the Casey is amazing.
Oh my God.
I'm awake.
But it wore him down too, Linda, didn't it?
It did. Well, the thing about psychics, people take advantage of what you know. Right. We are such a high level of frequency with the brain and outside the body, and picking stuff up like a spring, that it's hard to stay focused in the material world and grounded at the same time. So it is very draining, and people don't understand why I can be in a clinic and I can be helping somebody detoxing from a drug. I can be helping somebody crossing over to the dynamic transfer. Well, I could be reading on the phone or Zoom. And after several, I'm exhausted and drained. And it's like, people don't understand, you gotta replenish. I mean, I'll just wash my face, you know? It's not the same as just going out for a drink and party. It's a whole different feeling. And yes, it's draining to the point. Sometimes I'll just sleep it off. I don't want to socialize because I've taken on so much. But I don't ever remember being like this as a child where I would get drained and tugged and so on. It's a big responsibility, but the average person doesn't understand. You do.
What would you say is the most satisfying aspect of what you do?
You know what I love the most is when someone says thank you, or wow, it worked, the candles are great, your prediction came true.
Or you saved me or something.
Yeah, when I get the confirmation that I touched a life, that I actually made a difference.
That's a great feeling.
Yeah, I mean, look, you touch lives every single night for years. People come to you to hear you and all your guests because you created this amazing show after all these years, and the way you handle yourself and all the questions is so natural. It's you, it's your show, and you touch lives. People stay up all night to hear you.
It's one of the reasons why, Linda, we do live stage shows. I'm doing one in October in Everett, Washington. I like seeing our audience up front, live in person.
I've done that, yeah. I would travel when I was on cable radio. I traveled into different cities, and I would meet people who would listen to the show. It's wonderful to see the people who support you or me without just being on the phone or on the air.
Yeah, I feed on the roar of the crowd.
You have to. I've seen you a couple times, like at Conscious Life, or, you know, in action or whatever. But no, the actual person needs to see who they're talking to, and then you get a vision in your mind what they look like, and you meet them, and it's nothing like you imagined, you know, or you hear the voice. But that's the fun part.
Well, let's take some calls with you when we come back. Get ready, folks. Line up. Tom will get the calls, and we'll pass them on to Linda.
Find out more about tonight's guest. Log on to coasttocoastam.com.
Scratching off with her coffee and her donut every morning.
The Tim Conway Jr. Show.
Weekdays at 6
on KFI.
The podcast Wheel Woman tells the true story of Georgia Durani, all-American girl, world-famous model, and getaway driver for the mob. Wheel Woman takes you on a thrilling ride through the unlikely life of one beautiful, smart, fascinating woman.
The rules were simple. Don't talk to anyone. Don't ask questions. Always park a block away. Make sure you're not being followed.
Listen to Wheel Woman on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts. Brought to you by DuckDuckGo. Search, browse, and email privately, all for free with the DuckDuckGo app.
As parents, we've done everything possible to protect our kids from COVID-19, from using hand sanitizers to masking up. But now we have the most important tool, vaccines. They help protect our children and the entire family. And it's okay to have questions. Ask your doctor about the COVID-19 vaccine for your child. Or visit vaccinateall58.com to learn more and find a vaccine near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Our windows have a story to tell. Shouldn't yours?
My name's Mike Jackson.
Elias Areola.
What sets American Vision Windows apart is their investment in their employees.
The Bill and Kathleen way is investing in you, and it's contagious.
They are putting back in the company, and that's why this company is where it's at today.
American Vision Windows continues to revolutionize the home improvement industry, one customer at a time, while changing the lives of our employees for the better.
Happy employee, happy customer.
My old windows heated it up like a brick oven, and now it's completely climate controlled. Can you tell I love these guys?
See the difference that new windows can make in your home.
For a limited time, American Vision Windows offers a whole house of windows for $99 a month or free expert installation. Oh. Call 888-226-9908.
Catch the vision. Catch the vision.
see website for details. Offer expires 6/30/2022. CSLV number 778326.
Phone, car radio, smart toaster, we don't care how you listen, just that you do. KFI and KOST HD2, Los Angeles, Orange County. It's time for your morning wake-up call. Here's Jennifer Jones Lee.
Good morning, and welcome to the first day of June. How do we make it halfway through the year already? Or into the at least 6 months already? Lots to talk about on your wake-up call this morning. Thanks for joining me. And here are some of those stories. Congressman Adam Schiff says he wants to give people a break from the federal gas tax. A man and woman in San Bernardino County have been arrested for abusing and torturing five kids for 4 years. 505, we're going to talk with ABC's Karen Travers. President Biden is teaming up with Fed Chairman Jerome Powell. And you could say the two are sort of plotting. Plotting to come up with a plan to fight inflation. And also, the president wants to show voters that, you know, he's in tune with their worries, with the cost of gas and groceries and all of that going up. We'll find out more about what the two met about yesterday and what actually got done at that meeting. And then this is the story that I think is, it's blasphemous. Honestly, how can you go to a movie theater and not have the ability to buy popcorn, right? It's like peanut butter and jelly, macaroni and cheese, movie theaters and popcorn. Nope, movie theaters say there could be a popcorn shortage.